I remember like it was yesterday. We came up together. Jim was a rising star. He took me along for the ride. Corruption in the department was an open secret. No way Jim was gonna let it slide. Jim kept me on the straight and narrow. They can say what they want, but it was a setup. Simple as that. Honorable cop in Seneca? Jim never stood a chance. Prison couldn't have been easy, even for someone like Jim.
Today marks the day as Seneca City's murder capital of the U.S.
I hereby declare that as of today, the Seneca Enforcement Act is in effect.
As your new DA, I can promise you this. We will turn the tide.
In an unlikely turn of events, former Super Cop Jim Baylor has been exonerated.
It's good to see you, Jim. Sorry for the less than frequent visits. People talk, you know? Can't give them the excuse. Not that I give a damn no more. I should have left after what went down. But life on the force is behind me. Independent now. Just like I always talked about. Pension be damned. Left 3 years ago. As soon as they passed the SEA, every clown ex, cop ex, fed ex, whatever, was lining up to start their own agency. Goddamn feeding frenzy. Seneca Enforcement Act. Crime rate got out of control after you went down. So much so, they straight up torched the red tape on private agency regulations. SCPD can't handle it. Or won't. So now it's on the agencies to pick up the slack. Work to go around like you wouldn't believe, and carte blanche to lay down the law. Bounties, recoveries, security contracts, you name it. With the authority to bring in perps, asset recovery, access to warrants. It's wild, Jim. City's going to hell. But all that work? I had to take advantage. But you know as well as anyone, I ain't exactly the calm and rational type. Never been much of a diplomat, either. Some of the types I had to deal with on agency biz really bent me out of shape. I maybe torched a few bridges. You got me. I need you, Jim. Come on, buddy. I wouldn't be asking, but you've always had my back. Been that way from high school right through to the force. We bring out the best in each other. I knew you'd come through. Like I said, bridges burned, yada yada yada. Long and short of it is, some big jobs fell through, and I'm short on rent for the office this month. Short, but it doesn't matter. I've got a thing or two lined up. When they hear Jim Baylor's calling the shots, they'll eat it up. Your name's clean now. Client don't like me, but with your face on the agency, that changes things. You pull off a few jobs that restores trust, you know. Penny and Larry keep the lights on. They deserve better, but don't tell them that. Place would fall apart without their support. True though that may be, who can say no to this face? Anyways, this is the agency. Not much to look at, I know, but like I said, it's a fixer-upper. In order to accept cases, you need to talk to case officers in the agency. Cases are tied to caseloads. A caseload consists of several cases. Case officers can give you caseloads, which consist of individual cases that need to be completed. All right, let's get the ball rolling here. Accept your first caseload.
This is a top priority security contract. Heading out now. How about this weather we're having, huh?
I've heard good things about your agency. I hope you can help me with this.
Thank you. Destination reached. Contract successfully completed. On it. A location.
We're going to need some security personnel.
I need your best agent on this security detail. On my way. I've arrived. Contract completed. Rolling out. I'm here. that's a wrap.
We need your support on the security contract.
Consider it done. Location reached. Contract failed. We'll have to do better next time.
See? It's pretty straightforward. You can see the caseload results here. When enough reputation is gained with an individual case officer, rewards can be unlocked.
Thank you.
each case officer offers a specific type of contract. When caseloads are completed, reputation with the individual case officer is either gained or lost. Running the agency is one thing, but if we want to really make a name for ourselves, we need to up our game. It's a dog-eat-dog world, and we have an opportunity to deliver rough justice, especially with the implications of the new Seneca Enforcement Act. One way of doing this is to tackle operational leads. Each operational lead has specific requirements. Once those are met, then it's made available.
Hi, I'm Larry. I'm the case officer in charge of 24/7 cases. Now, some may argue that they're not as lucrative as other case types, but these are the bread and butter of any respectable agency. Besides that, if you keep me and my clients happy, the potential rewards are well worth it.
I need your best agent on this security detail.
We need your support on this security contract.
Location. Contract successfully completed. Rolling out. Location reached. Contract completed. Thank you.
All right. Good job with the caseload. Remember the Black Valkyries? Biker gang. Probably not, as they were small time when we rumbled with them back in the day. Well, apparently now they're the big kids on campus. Sudden influx of cash and a ton of new members. Feels off to me. Used to be they'd stick to the outskirts, but lately they've been absorbing smaller crews and making moves in the city. They're operating hard and heavy. Raids and killings against other gangs. Gone from skirmishes to out-and-out turf wars. I don't know where they're suddenly getting all this cash, but it don't bode well for the city. According to a buddy of mine on the force, a former Black Valkyrie chump by the name of Zippy is in hot water over a traffic stop. Zippy crashed his ride during a delivery for the Valkyries and lost whatever he was carrying. Cops show up, he sees red, and ends up spending the night in a cell, and his chopper becomes collateral for the bail money. You ask me, he's a good in for the Black Valkyries. Might give us a bit of insight into how they're expanding so quickly. A loser like Zippy lives for his bike, and will probably do just about anything to get it back. He's no fan of the law and no doubt susceptible to acts of generosity, so a softer approach might get his tongue flapping. Send over a suitable agent. Let's see what Zippy knows.
I've heard good things about your agency. I hope you can help me with this. On my way. I'm here. Thank you.
Contract successfully completed.
I've heard good things about your agency. I hope you can help me with this.
Now. I've arrived. Thank you. Contract completed. I've heard good things about your agency. I hope you can help me with this. Destination reached. Contract done.
I've heard good things about your agency. I hope you can help me with this.
Hey, consider it done. Thank you. contract failed. We'll have to do better next time.
Keep them coming. Great job with the caseload.
Hi, I'm Penny. I'm the case officer in charge of repossession cases. These cases involve the retrieval of collateral or outstanding rented or leased vehicles. The majority of my clients are debt collection agencies, which pay a pretty penny. It's imperative that we focus on repossession cases if we want to make a name for our agency. I'm relying on you to make sure that these case types are taken care of.
Some security personnel.
Location reached. That's a wrap. I'm fading here. I hope I don't fall asleep at the wheel. Location.
I need your best agent on this security detail.
Hey, consider it done. I'm here. contract successfully completed. We're gonna need some security personnel.
Consider it done. Location reached. I need some R&R, or I'm gonna lose it.
I'm impressed with the results of your caseload.
Detail.
I've heard good things about your agency. I hope you can help me with this.
Consider it done. Destination reached. Contract failed.
I've heard good things about your agency. I hope you can help me with this.
Rolling out. Location reached. Contract completed. Heading out now. On location. That's a wrap.
I'm impressed with the results of your caseload.
Your help locating the vehicle.
on my way. Suspect's vehicle located. Contract successfully completed.
All right, good job with the caseload.
Hey, I'm Vijay. I'm the case officer in charge of fugitive recovery cases. These cases involve locating and retrieving fugitives who've fled to avoid court appearances. Apprehending these fugitives and ensuring that they arrive on time for their trials is the prime directive. Besides the various tiers, there are three different danger categories of fugitive recovery cases, being low risk, medium risk, and high risk. Low risk. If your agent does not manage to locate the fugitive within the allocated time, then 3 action points are deducted from your agent. Medium risk. If your agent does not manage to locate the fugitive within the allocated time, then 10 action points are deducted from your agent. High risk. If your agent does not manage to locate the fugitive within the allocated time, then 20 action points are deducted from your agent. You can accept as many fugitive recovery cases as you like.